Hello everyone. Today let's discuss few questions on sodium, potassium and chloride. First question, hyponatremia. For 1 marks, it can also be asked for 2 or 3 marks as well. So if it is just for 1 marks, you can just give the definition. What is hyponatremia? Hyponatremia means it is a decrease of sodium level in the blood. That is, it is if it is less than 135 millimole per liter. If the sodium level is less than 135 millimole per liter, it is mentioned as hyponatremia, and it is due to the water retention. And you can also mention what are the causes. According to the marks, you can mention the causes and the signs. If it is just for 1 marks, you can give the definition, and it is due to the water retention, and causes may be due to vomiting, diarrhea, etc. And signs will be like lethargy and BP variation and dehydration. That are the signs that you can mention for 1 marks. If it is more than for 1 marks, you can mention more of signs and causes. Other signs and causes also you can mention. Next question, that is the normal values of serum electrolytes. That is, you need to mention about sodium, potassium, bicarbonate and chloride. Sodium, it is 136 to 146 milli equivalents per liter or millimole per liter. Then chloride, it is 96 to 106 millimole per liter. Potassium, it is 3.5 to 4.5 milli equivalents per liter. Bicarbonate level in adults, it is 23 to 30 milli equivalents per liter. So all these values should be by heart. The third question, it is to mention the normal value of sodium and the clinical manifestation of hyponatremia. Hyponatremia, before mentioning hyponatremia, you can mention about the normal sodium level, that is 136 to 146 milli equivalents per liter. You need to mention the unit, only then the normal value, you will get a full marks for the normal value. Always there should be a unit. Next, you need to give the clinical manifestations of hyponatremia. So just give the definition of hyponatremia, that is decreased sodium levels in blood, that is less than 135 millimole per liter, and it is caused due to water retentions. The signs and symptoms include dehydration, drop in BP, lethargy, confusion, tremors and coma. And causes of hyponatremia, it is vomiting, diarrhea, burns, Addison's disease, then renal tubular acidosis, reabsorption of sodium if it is defective, then chronic renal failure and nephrotic syndrome where excess sodium is being excreted by the kidneys through urine, then congenital heart failures and hyperglycemia and ketoacidosis. All these are the causes of hyponatremia. Then the treatments for hyponatremia depending upon the causes and duration and the severity, you need to treat the patient. If it is acute hyponatremia, rapid correction is possible, but in chronic cases, too rapid corrections may increase the mortality by neurological complications. Then effect of administrated sodium should be closely monitored, but only after allowing sufficient time for the distribution of sodium that is required for about 4 to 6 hours is required for the equal distributions of sodium to various organs. Then water restrictions, treatments include water restrictions, increased salt intake, then furosemide and anti-ADH drugs. These are the basic treatments for hyponatremia.